Any idea where we are now?
Yes, we're heading towards a famous film set where two stars of the future were about to make an appearance.
It's 8 o'clock on November the 2nd, 1982. Channel 4 is barely 3 hours old and its new soap opera is just beginning. It was named after a close of new-build houses in West Derby called Brookside. Ricky and I played Sheila and Bobby Grant, the mum and dad in a working-class family who just moved into number 5.
Hey, look at this. Look at that.
My goodness, that brings a few memories back, doesn't it, kid?
Oh, my goodness, hey? Me, it certainly does.
The show's creator, Phil Redmond, had worked briefly as a surveyor, which may have given him the idea of using a close of rail houses rather than building a set, and he bought them all. A very sound investment.
It was a really clever concept, wasn't it?
It was a great idea.
The houses had great big holes in the walls where all the wires and the leads came through for the cameras. It was the thought of how they adapted it all as well, like that long run of houses there. That was the edit suite up there. And then the canteen in that house and then us. It made it real, didn't it, Rick?
It was real.
Before Brookie, Ricky had only one acting job in the BBC play for today, United Kingdom.
What about the bloody big wages that have been shouting for months? What are you going to do about it now?
Where he was spotted by a Brookside writer.
I believe in luck and I believe in fate. When that's being shown on a Saturday night, Andy Lynch, one of the writers, he's watching the telly and he's seen me on the screen and said, we've just spotted Bobby Grant. That was it.
Sooth Pat to Brookside came via the cobbles of Coronation Street.
There was somebody I knew at Granada, and they were casting for this part of Mrs. Chadwick in Coronation Street. I did 2 episodes, and then I had to go back for a third, and during that gap, I got sent for an audition for Brookside, and it's going to be filmed in Liverpool, and I thought, oh, that would be great. So that's why I had Brookie and not Corrie.
Unlike other soaps, Brookside embraced a socially diverse cast with middle-class and working-class families cohabiting in our cosy cul-de-sac.
Paul, are you listening?
That's a hard-faced little bugger.
It certainly struck a chord with viewers, with audiences peaking at 9 million.
David! Come here.
Bobby Grant, I suppose, are very similar to me in real life, you know.
Now, you two, pop it, you, inside.
I hate that!
Now!
That part was all very, very easy, you know.
When I was younger, I was a bit fiery like Sheila.
Oh, Bobby!
And now I'm getting older and losing my faculties. I'm probably like Barbara.
He's married to Cindy Crawford.
Brookside regularly made the papers with hard-hitting storylines.
It was amazing how quickly the public took to it.
Yes.
And the fan mail. And I've told this story a million times about I was giving you a bad time in the storyline.
Bad time is an understatement. Bobby got violent. And viewers took Sheila's plight to heart.
And we got that letter. And it said, Bobby Grant, you should be ashamed of yourself the way you're treating Sheila, and by the way, you've got the biggest, squarest head in television. And we put the letter up in the canteen.
But there was more trauma to come for Sheila Grant.
The producers called me in and said, we want to put something to you and see how you feel about it. We want to have Sheila Grant raped, the character raped. And I thought, oh, crikey, OK.
This storyline was a challenge for me. 10 years earlier, I had also been attacked by a stranger on my way home in London.
We had lots of talk and we said we'd involve rape crisis. And then they said how they were planning to do it and it was exactly the same. Somebody running up behind and grabbing you by the throat. And I thought, God, I don't know how I'm going to be able to deal with this. Because I'd never really dealt with it.
Sheila?
But it was almost like a release because reliving them, reenacting, gets rid of the pain somehow for lots of things.
She...
Storylines like these set Brookside apart and made household names of those involved.
We had some great writers on it. I mean, you know, lucky to have Jimmy McGovern churning out scripts for you. Andy Lynch. Oh, there were so many. And first-rate actors who've gone on to have stellar careers. Changed my life, really.
Absolutely.
It was fabulous.
Absolutely. And yet I'm still waiting for that call from Hollywood, you know.
Oh, you love
it. Yeah, I think I've missed it a couple of times.
I think I've missed it as well. Never mind. We haven't done too badly.
We haven't done.
More memories.
That was lovely.
Yeah, great.
Happy stuff. Days.
Tally ho, Brookie.
Cheerio.
I owe you a lot. Tatty bye.